PS4. I believe this is part 19. I think last time was part 18. This is part 19. Oh, it's you, huh? Do you know what I am? I don't. I feel anything at all. I was saying. What happened? What? He disappeared in front of you? Back here for now. New case just came in that's cause for concern. Could be related to what you just witnessed. This case comes from old man Mizushima. You might remember him as the one behind those four urban legends you recently investigated with the occult club members. It will and truly is a small world out there, even when it feels bigger than ever in some ways. Anyways, he's tasked us with tracking down his cat. Frankly, during times like this, there's something to be said for a down-to-earth gig like this one. Mizushima said he'll be waiting for you at K-Cafe, although he didn't exactly actually state when. It wouldn't hurt to go ahead and check things out at the cafe, so go do that. Yeah, the later in the game you go, the less your body actually, your digital body actually wants to stay in the real world. Start to destabilize. Have a seat. Stay as long as you like. No, I didn't feel anything that hurt. So, oh man, Mizushima is not in right now. Alright. You usually met him there early in the morning, right? As well come back around the same time. Can't see if he shows up. Oh, it's you again. I've been waiting, you know. Oh, you stopped by yesterday afternoon, but couldn't find me? You must have just had bad timing, kid. I've been waiting forever for you. What's done is done. Let's just let bygones be bygones. Start searching now. Might make you see he's inside the wall, this wall here. K-Cafe right now. Picking up reading a very strong digital wave vibration on the fourth floor. It's a really huge current coursing through there. My money's on that old time castle being the cause of the... Is that earthquake? No, I confirm it's definitely not. There's no lines that computer is hooked up to. So much so, in fact, that they're forming a cybernetic new line, a digital line. So if this thing persists, it's only a matter of time before it affects our belt in the real world. I need you to go inside the back of your computer and do what you can do. I'm coming in. That death animation. large fish appears in the
Thank you.
can do the girl consulting and if she just I don't feel bad. I also just love hearing if she's talking and she's so happy. Thank you. Broadway construction for a while. The basement of Broadway once housed a backup computer logistics as well. It had been brought into the building after the end of World War II by war criminals who evaded arrest, shielded from the prying eyes of MacArthur's GHQ. The backup computer surface in those days remains open. It's possible it could have been utilized for things such as mathematical computations or code breaking, but some speculation is that confirmed. As time went on, there was eventually nobody left to carry out the original purpose set forth for the terminal. At that point, the computer was there for a long time. Hold on, I can't see a thing. It's okay, I'm okay being a star, but I'm not scared of it or anything. But it's never been this bad before. She was fine. Computer, vacuum tube computer. And I, somebody, anybody, tell me.
Muri shicha dame da yo.
Looks like the tremors have stopped, just in the nick of time, too. That's my assistant for you. Well done. You've done well. Now I don't have to worry about any broken coffee cups. Maiko, is that really you? Yoshito, I'm so sorry. You've been waiting for me all for so long. I'm the one who should be apologizing here, Maiko. I'm the one who left you alone all this time. I'm sorry, my friend. No, it's okay, really. You don't have to be sorry. I know you've been waiting for me since the day I had to go. Oh, Michael. Thank you. If it wasn't for you, I'd have never lived to see Michael with my own eyes again. I should probably explain. You see, back when the vacuum tube computer room was still around, I lived here in this building, away from my family. The computer room was where I used to work. The only family I ever had with me the whole time was Michael. I've talked with Michael about everything there. My memories of my family, Fuyumi, Yuki, anything to keep my, or to help keep my loneliness at bay in there. He would join me in the computer room and we spent many, many hours together over the years. Eventually, they closed in the room and sealed the whole thing off with a thick wall, like it was never there to begin with. It's around that time that I lost Michael too. I couldn't find him wherever I looked. I had a bad feeling about where he might have ended up and came back here who knows how many times to rescue him. I have a feeling I know where the cat was actually. Because he's talking about an actual cat. Not a Digimon cat. I think his cat was trapped in the wall. But in the end, I couldn't do anything for him. I gave up, and over time, I nearly forgot about him. Before I knew it, it had been decades since we'd last been together. I can't thank you enough for making this happen. We couldn't have reunited without you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Now we can go back to living together again. Thank you. I'll never, ever forget this day. I see. Nice work. I can only imagine how hard it was. You really did a good job. So RP actually had a cat named Michael sealed deep inside a wall, along with an old vacuum tube computer for the American occupation days. Somehow, using the building's internet, or rather the power of its Li Li, he merged with the computer and became a Digimon. That old cat had a hell of a life, wouldn't you agree? We can't say for sure what the actual assimilation process entailed, but at this point, we know better than to doubt it happened. It's amazing just how much, and yet how little, the digital and real worlds are siphoned off from each other. Imagine the reason Pete showed up after all these years is because of the digital wave is abnormalities we've seen. But you know, still one thing about the whole story that bugs me a little. You mentioned towards the end, old man said, now we can go back to living together again, right? What do you think he meant by that? But in case you but the case yourself earlier, where he was the one behind the urban legends, how did he keep breaking into the building? Let's assume, for the sake of argument, that he somehow had access to an entrance that let him come and go at the timing he did. If he'd physically been getting into the building so much that way he'd been reported, you'd think something would have got, and something would have gone differently. Your theories. How many theories you'd like to propose? Yoshito Mizushima. If you looked into his backstory, you might be able to find our answers pretty easily. What do you think? Should we dig a little more? Please, they must be Donko looking for. That's understandable. Then it's probably best we do indeed let things outside. Alternatively, we could let the occult club kids know about this. I bet they'd have a real field day going after it. I mean, they came face to face with a real. You know what? Nah, let's keep it to ourselves. All mysteries in this world need to be solved. The Necro Broadway brings many things together. The spirit world and the world of the living. The normal and the surreal. And now the physical and the digital. Truly nothing is impossible in this creative hole in the wall we call home. Okay, so I'm going to end this part here, just in case this like this ends this part, this ends this chapter, and I will start the next one, next chapter after. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. Of course, hit the notification bell so you get notified of all upcoming videos. And thank you and good night.